This was revealed during the candle lighting by Youth and Women Empowerment Foundation, YAWE, in Fort Portal.
Candlelight is an event which is done to stand in solidarity with people living with HIV and also pray for those departed friends due to HIV.
Akora George William, the director and founder of the YAWE Foundation, says that people living with HIV/AIDS are giving more attention to pastors than medical doctors.
But unfortunately, some of them believe so much in the pastor until they are too sick. And some of them, we actually lose them, but some of them who realize that now it's time to return on my medication, they return. But pastors, we need an intervention to mobilize them and also give them the same message that people can pray and also take medication.
The pastors who have them here, at times they also intend to confuse our people that they can pray for them and heal someone, get cured from HIV. This is a lie. If someone is positive, the only advice we can give is to go for medication and adhere to suppress the virus.
Records from Kabalore District Health Office indicate that the number of people on medication has dropped from 92% to 84%. The same records indicate that so far 236 people living with HIV/AIDS cannot be traced, while 19 of these have died. Editor Kasangachi, a team leader at YAWE, says the right to worship given to the people by the government has been taken for granted.
There is a church. In the gate we find there is a church. In the market there is a church. Those pastors, then we call them, all of them, they are pastors. And when someone comes, we test from the hospital or in the clinic. Someone runs away to go and start praying to the church.
According to the 2020 HIV/AIDS statistics by the Uganda HIV Impact Assessment Survey, Kabarole District and Fort Portal City stand at 14% HIV prevalence, making it the second highest in the country, with Kalangala District coming first at 18%. Marjorie Kansime, a councillor at YAWE Foundation, says the government should regulate pastors in the country to avoid challenges of uncoordinated and wrong messages to the people they lead.
To regulate these spiritual leaders, they should tell them the exact thing, that once you are HIV positive, you have to take your drugs. You have to take your ART drugs so as you can get better.
Records at Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital on HIV/AIDS performance for 2018-2019 show that the number of people who were on medication had reduced from 8,179 by October to December quarter to 7,988 in July to September 2019. The same records indicated that the retention rate of HIV/AIDS patients for the same period reduced from 91% to 82%. However, Pastor Frank Byabashaija of Anointed Soul Winners International Fort Portal says that much as they believe in God who heals and makes miracles, they don't stop people from getting medication.
We believe in the God who heals diseases, but we don't stop people from getting medication. Because doctors are given to us by God, and we believe in the doctors. I also go for medication.
Pastor Frank says it is always good for people to get their medication and challenges any pastor doing so to stop the act.
It is always good for people to get medication. Please, if there is a pastor or anybody, any religious leader who is hindering these people from getting their medication, it is wrong.
Kabalore District has a total number of 27,731 people living with HIV/AIDS, with a bigger number being women at 16,707, while men with HIV in the district are at 9,664, while children stand at 1,360. Story compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.